of my life forever. In addition to birthday cakes being important to me, decorating cakes has been an important part of my life as well. My grandmother was a baker and a cake artist and spent many years teaching me how to decorate. In fact, she had me in my very first cake decorating contest when I was 2 years old. I took home the gold ribbon, but my suspicion is that I may have had a little help. Today I'm going to show you how to decorate a cake with fondant. For many years, a butterfingered iced cake was what was popular. With the popularity of cake shows like The Cake Boss and Cake Wars, fondant decorated cakes have become the new most requested cake. With a little bit of help, some great directions, and a little bit of time, you can learn how to decorate a fondant cake as well. To start, I'm using a boxed fondant from the Will & Cake Company. This came in white, and I tinted it to pink, which was the color that I needed today. Once the fondant was tinted, I rolled it out on this nonstick mat with my fondant roller. Having the tools that you need make this job go a lot faster. I've went ahead and covered my cake. This is a chocolate cake filled with chocolate ganache, and I've covered it with two layers of icing. The first layer is called a crumb coat. The crumb coat keeps the cake pieces from showing up through your icing or your fondant. Now I've covered it with a layer of buttercream that our fondant's going to adhere to. Once we have rolled our fondant out onto our non-stick mat, we'll use our roller to pick it up. It's almost like a pie crust. We'll bring it over here, making sure that it has plenty of room to hang down. You can do a little adjusting, but not too much. The fondant is very pliable, and it stretches as well. To get a nice, smooth finish on your fondant, you want to use your hand and pulling the fondant out with the hand you're not working with. Rub the fondant and stick it to the icing underneath. You continue to work around in small sections. You can turn your stand. Just continue to pull this fondant out, push it down onto your cake. Now at this point, we have a lot of extra fondant. Almost got it down here. So I'm gonna take my scissors and cut off just some of the excess. I also use a pizza cutter for this a lot of times. We are almost done with our fondant cake. Take a little bit of powder on it. It's made with sugar, glycerin, unflavored gelatin, water, and vegetable shortening. We add flavoring so it doesn't taste terrible, but while fondant's beautiful, it is not super tasty. Now we've got our cake completely covered in the fondant. It's all perfectly adhered and smooth. I don't feel any bubbles in it. I will take my cake cutter, cut around the cake, trimming off all of that excess. Peel it off. Once this is done, our cake is going to be ready to transfer and put the finishing touches on. Thank you so much, and this is how you fondant a cake.